Hello, Dr. Sushma Singh, on lecture of chapter 6, Democratic Resurgence. Now let us start politics after emergency. The most valuable and lasting lesson of emergency was learnt as soon as the emergency was over and the Lok Sabha elections were announced. The 1977 election turned into a referendum on the experience of emergency. At least in North India, where the impact of the emergency was felt most strongly, the opposition fought the election on the slogan of Save Democracy. The people's verdict was decisively against the emergency. The lesson was clear and has been reiterated in many state level elections thereafter. Governments that are perceived to be anti-democratic are severely punished by the voters. In this sense, the experience of 1975 to 1977 ended up strengthening the foundation of democracy in India. Now let us discuss Lok Sabha elections in 1977. In January 1977, after 18 months of emergency, the government decided to hold elections. Accordingly, all the leaders and activists were released from the jail. Elections were held in March 1977. This left the opposition with very little time, but political development took place very rapidly. The major opposition parties had already been coming closer in the pre-emergency period. Now they came together on the eve of the elections and formed a new party known as Janata Party. The new party accepted the leadership of Jayaprakash Narayan. Some leaders of the Congress who were opposed to the emergency also joined this new party. Some other Congress leaders also came out and formed a separate party under the leadership of Jagjivan Ram. This party, named as Congress for Democracy, later merged with the Janata Party. Janata Party made this election into a referendum on emergency. Its campaign was focused on the non-democratic character of the rule and on the various excesses that took place during this period. In the backdrop of arrests of thousands of persons and the censorship of the press, the public opinion was against the Congress. Jayaprakash Narayan became the popular symbol of restoration of democracy. The formation of the Janata Party also ensured that non-Congress votes would not be divided. It was evident that the going was tough for the Congress. Yet, the final results took everyone by surprise. For the first time since independence, the Congress party was defeated in the Lok Sabha elections. The Congress could not win only 154 seats in the Lok Sabha, its share of popular votes fell to less than 35%. The Janata Party and its allies won 330 out of 542 seats in Lok Sabha. Janata Party itself won 295 seats and thus enjoyed a clear majority. In North India, it was a massive electoral wave against the Congress. The Congress lost in every constituency in Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Delhi, Haryana and Punjab, and could win only one seat each in Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh. Indira Gandhi was defeated from Raebareli, as was her son Sanjay Gandhi from Amethi. Congress did not lose elections all over the country. It retained many seats in Maharashtra, Gujarat and Orissa and virtually swept through the southern states. There are many reasons for this. To begin with, the impact of emergency was not felt equally in all the states. The forced relocation of displacement, the forced sterilization were mostly concentrated in the northern states. But more importantly, North India had experienced some long-term changes in the nature of political competition. The middle castes from the North India were beginning to move away from the Congress, and the Janata Party became a platform for many of these sections to come together. In this sense, the elections of 1977 were not merely about the emergency. Now let us know about the Janata government. The Janata Party government that came to power after the 1977 elections was far from cohesive. After the election, there was stiff competition among three leaders for the post of Prime Minister. Morarji Desai, who was the rival of Indira Gandhi ever since 1966 to 67, Charan Singh, leader of the Bharatiya Lok Dal and a farmers leader from UP, and Jagjivan Ram, who had vast experience as a senior minister in the Congress government. Eventually, Morarji Desai became the Prime Minister, but that did not bring the power struggle within the party to an end. The opposition to emergency could keep the Janata Party together only for a while. Its critics felt that the Janata Party lacked direction, leadership and a common program. The Janata Party government could not bring about a fundamental change in policies from these pursued by Congress. The Janata Party split and the government, which was led by Morarji Desai, lost its majority in less than 18 months. Another government headed by Charan Singh was formed on the assurance of the support of the Congress Party. But the Congress Party later decided to withdraw its support, with the result that the Charan Singh government could remain in power for just about 4 months. Fresh Lok Sabha elections were held in January 1980, in which the Janata Party suffered a comprehensive defeat, especially in North India, where it had swept the poll in 1977. Congress Party, led by Indira Gandhi, nearly repeated its great victory in 1971. It won 353 seats and came back to power. The experience of 1977 to 1979 taught another lesson in democratic politics. Governments that are seen to be unstable and quarrelsome are severely punished by the voters. Next point is legacy. But was it only a case of return of Indira Gandhi? between the elections of 1977 and 1980, the party system had changed dramatically. Since 1969, the Congress Party had starting shedding its character as an umbrella party, which accommodated leaders and workers of different ideological dispensations and viewpoints. The Congress Party now identified itself with a particular ideology, claiming to be the only socialist and pro-poor party. Thus, with the early 1970s, the Congress political success depended on attracting people on the basis of the sharp social and ideological divisions and the appeal of one leader, Indira Gandhi. With the change in the nature of the Congress Party, other opposition parties relied more and more on what is known in Indian politics as non-Congressism. They also realized the need to avoid a division of non-Congress votes in the election. This factor played a major role in the elections of 1977. In an indirect manner, the issue of welfare of backward castes also began to dominate politics since 1977. The results of 1977 elections were at least partly due to the shift among the backward castes of North India. Following the Lok Sabha elections, many states also held assembly elections in 1977. Again, the northern state elected non-Congress governments in which the leaders of the backward castes played an important role. The issue of reservations for other backward classes became very controversial in Bihar, and following this, the Mandal Commission was appointed by the Janata Party government at the center. The election after the emergency set off the process of this change in the party system. The emergency and the period around it can be described as the period of constitutional crisis, because it had its origin in the constitutional battle over the jurisdiction of the parliament and the judiciary. On the other hand, it was also a period of political crisis. The party in power had absolutely majority, and yet its leadership decided to suspend the democratic process. The makers of Indian Constitution trusted that all political parties would basically abide by the democratic norm. Even during the emergency, when the government would use extraordinary powers, its use would be within the norms of the rule of law. These expectations led to the wide and open-ended powers given to the government in times of emergency. These were abused during the emergency. This political crisis was more serious than the constitutional crisis. Another critical issue that emerged during this period was the role and extent of mass protest in a parliamentary democracy. There was clearly a tension between the institution-based democracy and democracy based on spontaneous popular participation. This tension may be attributed to the inability of the party system to incorporate the aspirations of the people. With this, we come to end of the today's lecture. Thanks for the listening.